for most Singer Studio Silver Reed machines, to cast on, the weave and cast on, you would bring your needles out to work in position that you want to work. And I always start opposite the carriage, and I will take every other needle and bring them out to hold in position. I will thread my yarn through my carriage, lay it over the needles and hold in position. But I also need to put my front brushes down. On some machines, you can control the back lever, like here on the 155 and also the 860. I would bring the side levers forward and again bring the front brushes down. Then you're going to knit across. Now, you could do a couple rows like this with your carriage set up in this way. Actually, for the brother machines, you could also do this with the front brushes down. But there's going to come a time when you're going to need the cast-on comb. Now, I could probably keep going like that, but I want to weight down the edges here. So I'm going to put my claw weights on the end stitches now that I have the enough there to hang them. I'm going to take my brushes and put them up now. On the other machines, you're going to take the side levers and put them back and just continue knitting. You would do the same if you wanted a closed cast on. So you bring your needles out, do an E-wrap, latch tool cast on, double E-wrap, knit it on, cast on, whatever you want. And then you have your brushes down, knit across, knit about 4 to 6 rows maybe. Well, I'm seeing the end stitch there is not knitting, so it's time for me to put on a claw weight on the ends. And then continue my knitting. Now the Mylar sheets that came with this machine, the designs are all on the left here. You can see this one, well, it's 36 stitches wide. This one here is 19 stitches wide. You can see the little arrow on there. Now, I misplaced my number one card for this machine, so I went and got my card from the EC1, which would be an external card reader on the back. Anyways, this has the built-in card reader. So first of all, I need to set my card. I line up the bottom. I pick the number one card, which is every other needle, the first row, opposite every other needle, the next row. Now this one here is 24 stitches wide, so I make sure if I was to have my pattern width all the way over here, the card reader is going to read that whole thing. So I only want it to do this little area here, which is 4 rows. It could do it 2 rows and then reset itself, but the card's already set up for 4 rows. I need to put the card down in, which is 10 rows in. Oops! Okay, sometimes I forget to press this top button here. But when that happens, I just take the thumb wheel, I line the bottom of that design again, press it down. I don't know if you heard that click click. Now it's ready to read. There's different things you could do here, which I won't get into. You do need to have your magnets already set up on the back of the bed here. I have 44 stitches casted on. I have my magnet set at 20 and 20. So the outside 2 needles are not going to work. I'm going to do a tuck stitch. So I set my cam on the carriage to tuck. And then I just start knitting, and after 4 rows, there is, on the side of the card here, you have 4 columns and then another column. At the top of the single column is the B, And then the four columns, you've got the middle ones, which is telling the card reader to go back to the bottom and start over again. Now, because I'm doing a tuck stitch, I want to have this weighted. So I have my triangle comb on with a small barrel weight along with the claw weights on the side here. Okay, what just happened was I didn't have the card put on the card reader exactly right. I have to have it down just a tiny bit more. What I did was I had it one up, so I want to make sure that I have it right there. And now it should knit properly. The last row it just showed it was tucking every stitch, which that's not going to work. There we go. So you want to make sure that you have the card right above the bottom of that design as you're working. Well, now I see something here that the end stitches are being tucked. Normally those should be knit. So I'm going to hand knit those, but I want to do something else. I am going to set my magnets to 22. Now, I don't want to touch a side on the carriage side right here. I want to go to the left side here because the magnets on the carriage is what reads these magnets to know where the design is. Now, on the right side, I'm going to move those magnets. But I need to hand knit one stitch here because it didn't knit properly. I guess this design doesn't have the beep on it, but it is working out the way I want it to. I've got this zoomed in on the card reader now, so hopefully you could see the card going up and down. Here you can see the plain stockinette stitch I did, and here is the tuck stitch. Here is the stitch that was knitted, and the one next to it has a stitch behind it, but also the yarn going over it as well.